The Mazda 6 went through a very significant refresh for the 2018 model year, but it isn't an all-new generation like the new Honda Accord and Toyota Camry. This is just a very thorough re-engineering of the model year before it. Although the sedan market might be dwindling down a bit, people are of course flooding the crossovers and SUVs rather than the traditional three-box sedan. There are still significant players in this category that are putting up a good fight. Some might consider calling this Mazda 6 all new a bit of a stretch, but it is significantly refreshed. It's got an all new exterior, an all new interior. There's been significant changes to the suspension system. This 2.5 liter engine is the turbocharged unit that comes out of the CX-9. That was one of the big headlines with this 2018, is that we finally have a more powerful engine under that bonnet. But we have thicker steel in some areas of the car, we have more sound insulation, and we have a bit more technology available to us as well. You do have very good turbo surge. There's a hint of lag, not too much though. When you compare the Mazda to the new Accord and the new Camry to the largest engine specification, so the 2-liter turbo in the Accord and the V6 in the Camry, here this turbocharged engine has 250 horsepower, 310 pound-feet of torque. It actually has more torque than both of those competitors. The V6 Camry has 267 and the Accord has 273. Now the important thing to note is that with that power output of 250, you can only get that number if you're using premium fuel. But if you're using regular grade fuel, the number is 227 horsepower. But the crucial thing to note is that the torque number doesn't change. And that figure is important because torque is what you're using to get the car off of the line. Standard equipment for the Mazda 6, the base GS trim, you'll get the dual zone climate control, the 8-inch touchscreen with their infotainment system, you'll have rear cross traffic alert, the rear view camera, blind spot monitoring assist system, and we are in the top trim signature model. So we have everything. We have everything you could possibly desire with safety systems. We've got a 7-inch display within the instrument cluster. We've got a heads-up unit. All of the outside seats are heated. The front ones are heated and ventilated. We've got a heated steering wheel. We've got paddle shifters. You really shouldn't complain about a lack of equipment with this car. Things that separate the signature model to all the other trims in the Mazda 6 lineup is in here we have this real wood trim that are on all of the door cards. That's a nice little touch. And we have this ultra suede trim that's here in the door cards and along the dashboard here. It really complements this deep brown chestnut leather that's throughout the interior, and it's a beautiful thing to behold. Pretty much everything is soft touch. I think the only hard plastics I can find are really down here in the center tunnel and down on the bottom of the door cards. If you're 6'4" like me, you are going to be very happy in these seats. There's a good amount of leg support. Could use just a tad bit more though. Really, there's only two things relating to the equipment that aren't so good. For one, the cameras. You have the rear camera, of course, but you also have a 360 degree camera system as well. And they really aren't good. They are so low res, it's rather surprising that they are in a brand new vehicle. My Mazda 3 from the year before this has a much better rear view camera. That is a real shame, in all honesty. And then the second thing is that the Mazda Connect system doesn't have Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. But Mazda told me that the 2019 Mazda CX-9 will be the first one to implement Apple CarPlay into the system as standard. And then after that car is launched, sometime in the fall, every Mazda that has this Mazda Connect system can be taken into the dealership and Apple CarPlay can be installed for a small fee. Mazda's mission is always to have the driver's oriented machine in their class of car. And it's no surprise that the Mazda 6 is a brilliant car to drive. There is wonderful weighting to this steering. The throttle response is pretty good, and if you put it into sport mode, it'll get a little sharper. You can shift the gears manually back here with a 6-speed automatic. I don't think this turbocharged engine is as exciting as the 2-liter turbo in the Accord. It still makes a decent noise. The Mazda doesn't actually have automatic stop-start technology, so when you're at a stop here, there's very minimal vibration, nothing to corrupt this pleasant driving experience, because this car is luxurious. For my perfect seating position up here, I don't have all that much space to sit behind me. The Honda Accord is definitely better for rear seat comfort for someone like me. And the Mazda Connect system, incredibly familiar to everybody that's ever come near it. It's a touch screen when you're at a stop, but when you're driving long, you have to use this rotary dial down here that is very sharp and precise. You have the shortcut buttons down here too. And I can't think of anything significant that I don't like about the interior. You still have that typical Mazda problem where the latches for the hood and the fuel cap just feel a little flimsy in their place. The gauge cluster can be customized to show off a few different things to you within the Speedo. I can say with confidence that this Mazda 6 is a fun car to drive, but it isn't a sport sedan with a crazy exhaust or a really level ride. You do have a slight bit of body roll. What the Mazda 6 is, simply, is a really competent and engaging car to drive. The 19-inch wheels we have on the Signature trim, I think, are the biggest looking 19s ever fitted to a car. And the way that it plays that visual trick on you is that they're really well set in place with the wheel arches. The sport mode will change the transmission mapping and the throttle response, but not much more than that. In the GS and the GSL, you still do have the 2.5 liter naturally aspirated engine. And that engine, if you want it so, can be paired up with a 6-speed manual. But that really is only set for the base trim. It is nice that Mazda still offers it, but the Honda Accord is definitely the king in class when it comes to setting up your powertrain with a manual, as both of those engines in the Accord can come with 3 pedals. I am thoroughly impressed with the 2018 Mazda 6. I feel the same way in this car as I did with that Honda Accord when I first reviewed it. It felt like a car that belonged in the class above. It feels like it should be competing against cars that do cost another $10,000-$15,000 more than it, like an Audi A4, like a Mercedes C-Class, because the interior is so well put together. We have wonderful materials all around, all the technology that you can really desire. So now I really have to face the decision, is this car better than the Accord? There's really only a few minor issues that I have with this car. I don't like the camera system. I think that's really quite an embarrassment, in all honesty. And I do want to buy a new car with Apple CarPlay. I have the confidence in knowing that Mazda will be implementing that system soon, seeing as I have to live without it for 2 or 3 months. I think I can stomach that. The thing that stopped that Honda Accord from being a 10 out of 10 for me was the exterior styling. I can't get over the way that thing looks. The Mazda 6 though, every time I park it up, I am looking back at it. I'm taking a few seconds to just take in how wonderful that exterior design is. So welcome everyone to the 2018 Mazda 6, my top pick for the midsize sedan segment.